The common rumor that Einstein has is he failed his math test when he is year four, but this is certainly untrue. Everyone, I believe everyone knows one of the most famous theorem in Euclidean geometry is Pythagoras Theorem. So we have a right angle triangle, and say we have a shorter side A, longer side B, and hypotenuse, which is always opposite the right angles. So we're gonna end up with A squared plus B squared equal to C squared. But do you know there are at least 400 different methods to prove Pythagoras Theorem? So you better know one of them. Firstly, let's talk about the history of Pythagoras Theorem. It was founded on a 4,000 years old Babylonian tablet in Egypt. So that's roughly 1900 before centuries. It's not well publicized until a guy named, not surprisingly, Pythagoras, a teacher and also philosopher, stated it very explicitly. That's roughly 6 years before century. He actually sacrificed 100 cattle the moment he proved his famous theorem. So Pythagoras theorem can sometimes known as 100 cattle theorem, which sounds a bit scary. Now let's talk about how Einstein proves his Pythagoras theorem when he is year five. So in 1949, he was interviewed and also he recalled the event when his uncle came to his house to teach him some geometry. And he's so confused about the way he explained Pythagoras theorem. That's why he decided to do his own. He started by drawing a right angle triangle, like what we did in the beginning. Let's call that side A, side B, side C. He produced a perpendicular height, just like that. And not surprisingly, right now, we are able to see three different triangles. Number one, the smallest, number two, and also the biggest, number three. Not surprisingly, number one, area, number two, equal to number three. He then drawing out each right angle triangles respectively. So say triangle number one with the hypotenuse A, triangle number B, two with the hypotenuse B, and the triangle number three with the hypotenuse C. And until now, everyone might realize those are similar triangles where the corresponding side are proportional and also the area ratio should be the square of the corresponding side ratios. However, the 11 years old Einstein does not know the fact, and this is what he ended up doing. He produced a square using the hypotenuse. In other words, the area of the square is A square. Similarly, B square. Similarly, C square. Now, although he does not know the theorem, but he knows each triangle has to be proportional to the square he just drew in a fixed ratios. What I mean by that is area number one has to be something called Ka square, where K should be the proportionality, which is between 0 to 1 in this case. And number two is Kb square, where number three is Kc square. Let's check them back into the formulas. Ka square plus Kb square equal to Kc square, where the K obviously cancels. And that's how he proves his Pythagoras theorem. The common rumor that Einstein has is he failed his math test when he is year four, but this is certainly untrue. He's actually 2 years younger than his mates. Also, he did well in his math and physics, but not the non-scientific subjects, which make his final result doesn't look good. He always jig and sleep in uni classes where his teacher described him as a lazy dog who never bothered about mathematics at all. Another thing year 12 students might realize is, did Einstein derive the most famous equation, energy equal to mc squared, from Pythagoras theorem? Because it looks like the C is coming from the A and B. Not really, because the C is representing of speed of the light, which is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, 300 millions. Another proof I usually use is by putting 4 congruent triangles together. So we have 1, CAB, 2, and extend a bit, 3. Not surprisingly, due to congruency, it's a square in the middle with side B minus A. It can also be seen the area of the small square plus the 4 right angle triangle should be equal to the area of the big square, C square. Hence, we are able to write this down. B minus A square plus 4 × ½ base × height equal to C square. Now, expanding the perfect square, we are able to have the Pythagoras theorem. That's it. At last, I'd like to show you guys some pattern Pythagoras theorem that holds. 3, 4, 5, 5, 12, 13, 7, 24, 25. And what should be the next? Well, by observing the pattern, we are able to see 2, 2, not surprisingly, the next one will be 9. Similarly, we have 8, 12. In other words, the next one should be plus by 16, which give you 40. At last, we are able to see 8, 12. Similarly, it should give you 41, because the next one you have to add 16, right? Okay, so some student might raise a question to me, say, what happened to 6, 8, 10 then? Well, there's lots of series in Pythagoras, and one of the series following the first pattern and the other series might follow different patterns. Thank you for watching.